Mr. Vitale, the pressure is on both teams in this third-round tournament game between the Duke Blue Devils and the Purdue Boilermakers. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Boilermakers are definitely going to have to fight to keep up in this one, Dick. What's the key to their success tonight?
I would say that these are the keys tonight. First of all, don't let them rain threes from the arc, baby. Second, get the ball inside for the high percentage shot. That'll open up the outside game as well. And lastly, make sure you take care of the rock. Turnovers kill momentum.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out.
Up and inside.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. And he missed. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
The center takes the feed.
Set that screen away. Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational. Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate. You better get rid of it, Brad.
They work the perimeter. Fake. He puts up the three ball. Way off target. On the outside. Inside. Takes the pass in the paint. Trying to draw some contact. He gets that one to fall. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
The small forward with the ball. With a little baby hook, they just can't seem to miss.
They've had a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. With a great block. Ivy's inferior play is really affecting his composure now.
Yeah, it's unfortunate to see this, Brad. I feel for him.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Goes in. Inside.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Doesn't go. Momentary look from three-point land. Bed the low block. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Puts it up, looking for contact. You betcha.
Inside.
Trying to pass.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
He'll regroup the offense. They've left him completely alone. The ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Shows patience, waiting for the reset. He uses the shot fake. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
The power forward takes the pass. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
For two. Perfectly executed. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He goes for three.
Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go.
Moving it around the perimeter on the inside. He's got a nice shot fake. Good defensive stance. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission. Oh,
the pick comes back to haunt the screener that time. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Here's the offensive drop step on a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Duke is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Had an open guy in the post and went the other way. He pulls the trigger. He buries it. The shooting guard gets the pass. Gets it to fall. Both teams looking to get things going here. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Look at that spacing. Great anticipation defensively.
Ivy is great right now.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Fakes it. They work it around the perimeter.
Dump it inside. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He gets the rejection. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Obvious foul. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
The Blue Devils are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. It's the first. Duke are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
He got it. Makes his third. They're whistled for a backcourt violation.
Those kinds of mistakes kill momentum opportunities. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
rims off. And they're catching nothing but iron at the free throw line, Dick.
They're going to catch more than that from their coach if they don't start putting them down, Brad.
Thinks about the shot. Got a nice screen. On the dribble, gives it up. He makes a nice shot fake. Makes a move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Tries for two, perfectly executed. Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
Shoots from outside. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their voice is beginning to fade.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Up for two, knocks it down, and the ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers could absolutely destroy a team.
Executes the baby hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
The block. Here they go into transition. You can't be the shot drops and the foul.
Great concentration on the shot, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. He sinks it.
The frustration right there.
Can't get the shot to drop. Time, the Blue Devils lead by 17. Looks like we're in for a whale of a game, Dick Vitale. Plays of the half, what's your pick?
Watch here, pounding the ball inside like you see. In this highlight, we'll take a lot out of the team on defense. I expect to see more of the same from both teams in the second half.
And now let's get ready for the start of the second half. Purdue turned the ball over quite a few times in that first half, Dick.
Their heads just aren't in the game. Some of the turnovers were unforced and plain silly, if you ask me.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Turnaround jumper. And he missed. The point guard receives the pass. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Here we go on the break for the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. The center gets the pass. He does the sweet fake shot. He pump fakes. Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Working it around the perimeter. Unloads a three. Makes it. Shot goes up and in.
Hey, there's just too much space.
Down in the low post. Defensive with great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying and film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post. Pushing that basketball.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Cross court.
Not getting enough motion on offense. Here they are in transition, Brad. Great play to take that to the basket.
They work the perimeter. Looking for the foul. Trying to draw the foul. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Momentary look from three-point land. Schaefer handles the pass.
Turnover City now always really negate any offense.
He looks at the hoop. There they come with a double team to stop it. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Gets a hand in the way. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
There they are on the low block, on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, do you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Ivy handles the feet. Basket's good, plus one.
He showed how a senior is supposed to play in big games, baby. Check out this young man, Brad. He's taunting the opponent.
He goes to the line for the first time. Got it from the free throw line. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing the ball. That's a 9-zip run.
Big time screen set on the defender that time. Schaefer receives the ball. It's no good. The shooting guard takes the pass. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Ted did a great job creating a good angle too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
The shooting guard takes the feed. There's the pick. He attempts the three. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Looks like only a miracle can salvage this one, Dick.
I'd have to agree with you, partner. Time's running out.
Steals the pass. drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
Atet just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops and do it now.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He's open if he wants the shot. Way off target. We're going to move it around the perimeter. For two. Perfectly executed. The Blue Devils have a player spotting up on the three. He puts up the tray. He misses it. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
He attempts a jump hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Too physical. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
High post flashes. Lobs it, and the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Dribble, gives it up from the baseline. They'll bring it out on top. Gave it up. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Move with a face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Great defense. On the dribble, gives it up. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. That ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
He launches the bomb. Rims out. Barring some sort of miracle, I think this one could be over, Dick.
It sure is, Brad. They have no chance of getting back into this one.
Up fake. He goes with a baby hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Picks off the lazy pass. High post flasher is open. He shoots from right of the circle. He makes the shot. Timeout. I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
misses it. The ball goes out of bounds. You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special. Coming inside.
Fakes the shot. On the outside. Ten on the shot clock. They'll work it around the arc. Gave it up. Kicks it out. Number 14 is called for the defensive foul. Second personal foul. On the dribble, gives it up. Picked out of the air. Looking for a good shot. There's the fake. And a momentary look from three-point land. Shot clock is dead. They move it into the front court. Moving it around the perimeter.
Look at that spacing.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Duke makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.